Well, say, this isn't a lady. How do you do, sir?
Glad to know you.
Mary, who is this distinguished gentleman here?
I'd like to meet Mr. Frank McGee.
Mr. McGee, welcome to Winner Take All.
Thank you.
We're awfully happy to... Where are you from, Mr. McGee?
Hampton Bays, Long Island.
What do you do out there?
Well, I'm a retired country gentleman now.
Yeah?
Spend my time gardening and farming.
What'd you do before that?
I'm a retired chief engineer of the city of New York and also a retired baseball player and umpire, where I spent 43 years.
You spent 43 years being a baseball umpire?
Between pitching and umpiring.
Pitching, umpiring, and chief engineer in New York?
Yeah.
How'd you find time to do all that, Mr. McGee?
Well, I used to do that on holidays, Saturdays, Sundays, and nights.
Holidays? That doesn't leave much, does it?
No, sir. I didn't have much time to myself between working and playing ball and umpiring during all these years.
You were kept pretty busy. Do you have any amusing stories? Anything happened to you while you were umpiring?
Well, one of the most amusing stories I had occurred and when I was umpiring a game at the Suffolk County Fair.
Mm-hmm.
I was behind the plate with all my chest protection and mask. And a friend of mine come up to me and he says, hello, Frank. Here's a nice big red apple for you.
You're in a ball game?
Yes, yeah. I was right behind the plate umpiring, calling balls and strikes.
Yeah.
So I put the apple in my pocket, not thinking. You know, we carry baseballs and umpires carry baseballs in the pocket.
Always have their pocket full of baseballs, yeah.
I went on a couple of innings, never thought a thing.
Yeah.
First thing you know, a foul ball or something happened that they needed a baseball. I just threw it out.
Threw it out.
Happened to be the apple? Yes.
That's all right. That must have gotten you quite a reputation, huh? I'll tell you what, Mr. McGee, we want to hear more about this baseball thing, but you threw the apple out there, and while the person who caught it is bringing it back, I wonder if you go over there and say hello to Dr. Tillman. I know you're in good health and all that, but that's Dr. Tillman. Dr. Tillman, Mr. McGee. Mr. McGee, will you take your place up there? You play sort of first base, close to the foul line there. And Mr. Tillman, you can be Yogi Berra. Mr. Tillman, Dr. Tillman, I'm sorry, I keep doing that to you. I'll tell you what, now, will you try the buzzer, please, Mr. McGee, sir? Mr. McGee and Dr. Tillman, that's right. You got three in there on me.
That's three strikes.
All right. Three. would you try the bell, please, ma'am? Are the rules the same in baseball as they always have been, Mr. McGee?
No, before 1888,
yeah.
I had an indicator.
Yeah.
That had four strikes and five balls.
Yeah.
That was used before 1888.
Uh-huh.
In 1888, the rule was changed.
Yeah.
To three strikes and four balls.
Four balls, yeah.
Yeah, that was okay. And I used that indicator all through my career.
Uh-huh.
And I gave that indicator to Red Barber.
Yeah.
That announces the ball games for the Dodgers.
Yeah.
And that indicator today is in the Hall of Fame, Cooperstown, New York.
Cooperstown, New York, that's where the indicator is.
Yes.
I'll tell you what, that is a pretty interesting story. As a matter of fact, I want to get back there and ask you more about that indicator. It's pretty good to have owned something originally that's now in the Hall of Fame, and I think you have something to be real proud of. But right now, what we want to do is pause ever so briefly. We're going to be back, the Winner Take All, in just a second with Mr. McGee and Dr. Tillman. But first, here's a pause for station identification.
Master of Ceremonies, Bill Collins.
Thanks. For the benefit of any of those of you who might just be joining our program, we will say that Dr. Tillman, who had just won when time was called yesterday, has successfully defended that championship of hers. She's now won two in a row. She's gotten $250, ROM, an Admiral refrigerator, and she has just been introduced to a very interesting gentleman who used to be a baseball umpire, Mr. McGee. Mr. McGee, would you move in a little bit closer to Miss... I guess that's close enough. We don't want to get you too... if you get any closer, we'll have to change the rules, you know.
I don't want to get too close.
How old are you, Mr. McGee? You talked about umpire.
78.
78 years old? Well, boy, you sure look hale and hearty. I was going to ask how old Dr. Tillman was, but I'm not going to ask that because she's a lady, and boy, ladies don't like to tell their ages. You know that, don't you?
I'm 21.
You're proud of what?
To tell my age.
Oh, I thought you were proud of Dr. Tillman's age.
Well, I am too.
All right, now, we got you two real close together. Now, this round coming up is just a little bit different. We're going to ask, if you will, Mr. McGee, to take your buzzer in your left hand. First of all, we're going to have to do something. First, I'm going to tell you. You know, this is a bottle round. Every day, all of us come in contact with various kinds of bottles. All kind of bottles. You know what I mean.
All kind of bottles?
All kind of bottles, yeah.
Well, from the time you're a baby up to...
That's right.
Time.
Every day. Yeah. We won't talk about...
That covers a lot of territory.
It sure does. There's a lot of bottles down the drain. Oh, anyway, I'll tell you what. Now, we're going to ask you to put blindfolds on. Will you be doing that? Mr. McGee, I guess you'll have to take your glasses off. Would you like me to hold them for you? No, I don't think that's safe. I'll tell you, because we're going to use that. You give me those now. Here you are. Will you give me a check for that, please? Pawnbroker back here. I hope they don't either. Put those blindfolds. See those blindfolds down there? Now, you two, just put your bell and buzzer down and get those blindfolds on. Meantime, I'll explain about this game. As we say, we all come in contact with bottles. Now, we're not going to see these bottles because our contestants are going to be all blindfolded, but we're going to give them a chance to feel the bottles. Now, when the blindfolds are on real tight, we're going to bring out some bottles here, but not yet. Would you get your blindfold on, please, Dr. Tillman? Mr. McGee, can you see anything?
Nope.
You're a real baseball umpire now, huh? You're speaking. I guess only blindfold we ever had with bifocals. Go back in there now. All right, goodbye. And Dr. Tillman, can you see anything?
No, I can't.
All right, girls, will you bring out our bit of display here? Here comes the display. Now, don't either of you look now from here on in. Here comes all kind of bottles that our two girls are bringing out. Aren't they lovely? And I don't mean the bottles. Now, Dr. Tillman, take your bell in your right hand and put your left hand to your left over there by Mr. McGee's hand. Will you, girls, will you help Mrs. Dr. Tillman get her hand on the pedestal there? There you are. Now, don't hold hands now, please, Mr. McGee. Remember, the baseball season hasn't started. Now, when I say go, the girls are going to put identical bottles into the hands of each of you. We want you, as soon as you can tell what that bottle is by feeling it, we want you immediately to sound your signal and then tell me what it is. Understood? All right, girls, stand by with the first bottle. Ready? Get set. Go. There they go. The bottles go into the hands. They're feeling the bottle now. My goodness, they're massaging the bottle. Your bottle's going to have... There's the bell first. What do you say, Dr. Tillman?
A 7-Up bottle.
7-Up bottle. No, I'm sorry. It is not a 7-Up bottle. It's a Worcestershire sauce. It's a Worcestershire Watts bottle. That's a wrong answer. That's a wrong answer for Dr. Tillman. So a free bottle grasp is coming to Mr. McGee. Would you take Mr. McGee's bottle there, please? The next bottle in line. The next one in line. That's right. And you eliminate yours, please, Marion. And let Mr. McGee feel that bottle. Mr. McGee, here's a bottle for you. Feel it. Now, tell me what it is. This is free. It's all yours. Yes.
Oh, that's a... A pill bottle.
Don't shake it. Don't shake the bottle. It'll blow up. No, I'm sorry. It's a bottle of ink, Mr. McGee. Bottle of ink, yes. Don't take your blindfold off now. Okay, still no score. Get ready, girls, with the bottles. You're both eligible this time. Ready? Get set? Go. See what this one is now, people. Come on. Feel all around it there, Mr. McGee. There's the bell. What do you say, Doctor?
A baby bottle.
A baby bottle, Dr. Tillman. That's the right answer. It is a baby bottle. It's a baby bottle. What kind of bottle did you think it was, Mr. McGee?
Well, I didn't know.
All right.
It wasn't the kind I use these days.
No, I... All right. The only thing I have to say, any man who keeps his pills in an ink bottle, you got to watch him. All right, now, both of you get ready. Here comes another one. Ready, girls? Get set. Go. Yes, sir. Feel this bottle good. Now, up and down, Mr. McGee. The girl hold it for you. Go ahead.
Oh, that's the bell bottle.
No, the bell first. What do you say?
It's a champagne bottle.
Champagne bottle is the right answer. Dr. Tillman came up with that. Come awfully big in your neighborhood, Mr. McGee. All right, now, 2-0 in favor of the champion. Get ready again, girls. Ready? Get ready with the bottle. Set. Here it comes. Go. See if you know what kind of bottle this is now. This is a pretty good... The bell first. No, the bell first. What do you say over there, Doctor? No, the bell first, Mr. McGee.
I believe it was syrup bottle.
Syrup bottle is the right answer, and the champion, congratulations. You're going to take off. Okay, girls. Well, the girls, sir, can I have Mr. McGee's spectacles back, please, just a second? There you are, Mr. McGee. So, thank you, sir, for being
here. Pleasure to meet you.
It was a real pleasure, and you're a grand sport, 78 years old, and you just go right over there for a third base, if you love Mr. McGee. Thank you, sir. He's all right. I want to say, Mr. McGee, I certainly enjoyed having you with us on the program today, and I know Dr. Tillman had a lot of fun. Hey, you're pretty good in the bottle department, Doctor. Gosh.
Well.
Huh? You sure know your bottle. Well, we won't go into that. I'll tell you what we're going to do right now. Let me see. You've won all these prizes. Don Pardo, suppose you tell the doctor what else she's won.
And for Dr. Miriam Tillman, a valuable addition to your dining pleasure. 6 complete place settings and lovely Westmoreland solid sterling.
Ooh.
The sterling silver you see at home by appointment. 36 pieces of Westmoreland's permanent pattern, George and Martha. And packed in a beautiful mahogany silver chest from Westmoreland sterling silver. Congratulations from winner take all.
You have win. You're really going great guns there, aren't you, Dr. Tillman?
I certainly am.
Silver, refrigerator, prom, money, wow. You never won anything?
Oh, maybe a dollar, that's all.
I never won a dollar. Mm-hmm. I won quarter once, but that was on another show. we want you to meet your next contestant. Marion James, who is it?